Welcome back to Got You, Got You. My name is Joseph. On my left.
My name is Heather. We're back. Do you have something to say?
Heather what?
Heather Fulmer.
Yeah. Anyway, how's your day?
It was good. Today felt so long for some reason, but...
It felt so long?
Very long. Like, the day went by really slow.
Do you know why?
Why?
Because you didn't have the podcast in the morning. That's why. And you didn't have any classes.
Yeah. And this is also my first weekend, like, being... at school since it started. So I like don't know what to do.
Oh, you don't know what to do.
Mm-mm.
Gotcha. What time did you get up?
Like 9.
9 o'clock. That's good. And then what did you do? You didn't have any classes.
What did I do? Woke up, made coffee, cleaned. Did laundry. Went to Starbucks.
Got.
The
pumpkin something?
No, I got a pink drink this time with vanilla sweet cold foam or something like that.
How'd you know about that drink?
I don't know. It was a popular drink, like TikTok and stuff.
Oh.
But like it's not trending now, like it's kinda old.
Yeah, gotcha.
What
time was that?
Like 12.
Okay.
And then I had a meeting with my advisor. And then... What did I do? Oh, I did some homework.
For how long?
Like an hour and a half, two hours.
Hour and a half and 2 hours. Did you finish it?
No.
How many hours do you think you have to do more to finish everything?
Like 2 more hours.
Okay. I like that.
Yep.
What time was that when you finished everything? The homework?
It was like 3.
Oh, 3. Okay.
So I was like, okay. I don't know what else to do. So then I needed to get my nails done really badly. Because I didn't get them done since like 3 weeks ago, maybe even a month. So they were like rough. So I did that, but then they couldn't take me until 5.
Mm-hmm.
So I just waited till 5, and then I went. That took like hour and a half.
Hour and a half to do your nails?
Mm-hmm. But I don't know why the guy was like, every time I go for some reason, like, I don't even know if you have girls ever watching your stuff. I don't think you do. It's always guys, I think.
I don't know.
But for some reason, whenever you go to the nail salon, they always do it differently. Even though you go to the same place.
They do
like different... No, actually, this place I've had a different person, I think, every single time.
Oh, okay.
But it was a guy doing it, but he was like... Oh my God, he was like taking his like time, which is like a good thing. But like he was doing all this like extra stuff.
Like what even extra stuff?
Like I don't know what the stuff is called, but like he was just like doing a lot more than what they normally would do.
Is it putting it on when he was putting it on or
no taking it off the old stuff?
Oh, when he was taking off.
Because normally
the
old stuff. Just put acetone and they do the foil and they put that, wait for that to soak and then they take it off and then they like use that drilling thing, and then they just start the new ones. But he was like doing like. This painting stuff.
After he...
No.
Even before?
Yes. Not nail polish. Like... This. Usually I've only seen it done when they do like acrylic nails. They take like that purple like liquid stuff with the powder. And I don't know what it is, but... Yeah. I don't know why he was doing that.
But even though your nail was not acrylic or something?
No, yeah.
Oh, so he made a mistake.
No, he didn't make a mistake. I just don't know what it was. But he was actually so nice because then when I left, I called you and I told you that I was taking an Uber back home, and there was like no Uber drivers. So it was like every person that I got was like 30 minutes away. So then I was waiting outside of the nail salon, and the guy that did my nails came out. He was like, "Why are you waiting?" I was like, "Waiting for my Uber." He's like, "Oh, where do you live?" I told him like downtown. He's like, "Oh, if you lived closer, I would have taken you home." Oh, like, "Aw, thanks."
Oh.
Yeah. So he's a nice guy.
Oh. So you were supposed to... He was supposed to put on the purple thing with the powder.
No, he was not supposed to. They don't usually do that.
Oh.
I don't know. Sometimes they just do like things differently. But
maybe he thought you had acrylic nails or something.
No.
You don't think he made a mistake?
No, they know if your nail is real or not.
Oh.
Yeah.
Maybe he was being like extra careful with it.
I think he was, because he really was taking his time.
Yeah, because your nail's been... Because after seeing that your nail's not healthy, maybe that's...
No, they always tell me every time I get my nails done that I have very strong nails.
Well, you're
every
strong
time
nails.
I get my nails done, they're like, "You have really strong nails."
Mm. Because whenever the girls take off their nails, it looks so ugly. Because of the scratches,
yeah,
it gets white.
Usually that... Like, if you just... kind of rip them off yourself.
Oh, that's when it gets...
Yeah,
white?
If you go to the salon and actually just tell them to take it off, it doesn't look like that.
Oh.
Because they take it off the right way versus you just like ripping them off.
Oh, okay. Because when I was going around, I saw some girls with just like white nails. Mm-hmm. It looked so ugly.
Yeah.
Oh.
I feel like I don't know anyone though that actually goes to the nail salon to just take them off. Because they get pissed at you if you go to the nail salon and you're just like...
If you did it by yourself.
I know, if you're just like, "Oh, I just want to take them off and I don't want to do anything. I don't want, like, a new set or anything. Just take them off and leave them plain." They get mad at you.
How long? How much is it?
It's not expensive, and I think that's why they get pissed. Because they know that they're not going to get enough tip.
Mm.
Like, one time I went and I was like, "Okay, I just want to do, like take off the gel and just do regular normal," because I wanted my nails to just grow out.
What do you mean normal?
Just regular nail polish, like,
okay,
whatever. It's very cheap, easy to do.
How much is it?
Like, some places is like $10 to $15. Very cheap
to take it off and put on like a...
Yeah,
I mean, of course you can just put your nail polish by yourself anyways,
right? Yeah, one time I went and they were like, "That's all you want? Regular polish?" I was like, "Yeah." She's like, "Okay, sit." Like, they were just so mad, you could tell.
Wait, was it that place?
No, it was a different place.
Where was it?
Back not home? In Ann Arbor, yeah.
Back home?
Mm.
Oh. Was it a guy or was it a girl?
Girl.
Oh, it was a girl. Like, good looking girl?
I don't remember. This was like 2 years ago.
Oh, okay, gotcha. Bad customer service right there.
Mm-hmm. I know.
Wow.
But nail salon people are very intimidating though.
Wait, why?
Like, they're so intimidating every time when when they ask you, like, "Oh, do you like it?" or they'll show you, you're just, "Yeah, mm-hmm." Oh. Like, you never want to be like, "No, can you actually like do it this way? Can you make them a bit shorter or whatever?" Like,
they have pride in their artwork. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So, yeah. What kind of character do they usually have?
Very serious.
Oh, serious.
Some people say, like, generally speaking, very serious. Yeah, I don't know.
Oh. So, when you mentioned the guy, in my head, he was a gay guy.
No. You know, he's, like, older. He's, like... 50s.
I was thinking late 20s, like mid to late
20s.
Oh, no. Oh, girl, yeah.
Oh,
got
no,
this
no,
with
no.
Like a lot of jewelry, tattoos.
No.
Short shorts.
No.
Yeah.
No, he's like an older guy.
Mm-hmm. Oh, well, how old do you think he is?
I don't know, like 50.
like a guy,
mm-hmm.
and he was good.
Mm-hmm. The guys are always better at doing the nails than the girls usually.
Oh, maybe they're more careful because, yeah, they're a guy. People think that they suck, and mm-hmm. they have to like.
He put his glasses on. He got to work. It was good.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
Very focused.
Oh, so he was 50.
Probably.
He was losing hair.
Yeah.
White?
No, Asian.
Asian. Oh, yeah. Asian. Everything that I imagined is going off my head now. I have to reimagine. Okay, he was an Asian.
Like, is it not what you expected at all?
I was expecting mid to late 20s, no, no. gay white boy.
No.
With short shorts. Mm-mm. Oh, gotcha. Wait. Where was he losing his hair?
In the middle.
Was it like straight up like...
Yeah. Like only on the sides he had hair. Like very cute guy though. Like sweet guy.
But who's the owner?
I don't know.
Oh, you don't know the owner?
I know. I never seen this guy in there before. The one that I went to today. It's always this like young girl.
Oh, like how young?
Maybe like mid-20s.
Oh. So she was the only one running?
No. Her, this other guy, also maybe 40s.
40 Asian.
Yeah. All yeah.
Well, what about the girl then?
Everybody's Asian.
Oh.
Yeah, that's how nail salons are though usually.
Actually.
Yeah.
When I think of nail salon, it's very like white people thing.
Uh-uh.
Oh, it's an Asian thing.
Yeah.
Like Asian, I think of Asian people when I think of massages.
Oh, okay.
They're all Asian, but nail salon is also
yeah.
Asian.
Yeah. Oh. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It was my first time, though, getting this guy.
Oh. Do you like him better than the previous one?
Honestly, they're all good. I've never gone to one of them and, like, hated my nails.
Got you. What did you get this time?
I just did pink.
Oh?
Pink.
What about one before?
Oh, the ones before?
Yeah, it was pink.
They were like light pink, but I did chrome as well.
What's
on top
chrome?
Of it.
Like a little...
No, they're like... I don't want to say sparkly, but kind of. It's like a... They take a...
Something that you put on, like a whole thing. You put it on, that's called chrome?
Yeah. Like, I don't know. You don't know.
You don't know?
You don't know.
Chrome. Is it like a little...
Can I just show you like an example?
That you put on?
But it was like a... Like, do you know like the Hailey Bieber nails? That was like everyone was talking about.
No.
She always did her nails like this, like chrome.
Chrome meaning?
Like, do you see how it's not like... It's like a sparkly kind of.
Oh, it's like a glass.
Yeah.
So it reflects.
Yeah.
Oh, that's called chrome?
Mm-hmm.
Then what do you call the one where you put on like a little pieces?
Like a design or something? Yeah, or you mean like when people put like gems or something?
Yeah, gems. What do you call those?
I guess like gems. I don't know.
Gem nails?
I don't know.
You don't know? Oh, okay, gotcha. He was 50. He was trying to give you a ride.
No, he did not. No. It's like your grandpa's trying to offer you
something. No, I'm just joking. Yeah. Asian people are very generous, though.
Yeah.
Yeah. Very caring. So what happened? How much time did you have to wait for the Uber?
Well, then I just... I kept canceling them until I got one that was like... the closest, so then eventually I got one that was like 10 minutes away.
Oh.
Right when I got in his car, he was like, he's an Indian man, he's like, "Hi, beautiful Heather," and then like, what? He's like, "I love that smile." He's like, "We need more people like you." So positive. He said, so positive, so much energy. He said that to me, actually.
Oh yeah, you have so much energy.
Mm-hmm. I don't know why whenever I get an Uber recently, they always start screaming at me about, like, they're not screaming at me, but then they'll start talking about some type of problem And then they start screaming.
Like, give me an example.
He was talking about homeless people.
Okay.
And he's like, this country has so many homeless people. They don't do anything about it. He's like, all these buildings have homeless people sleeping under them. Blah, blah, blah. Like screaming. Mm. I'm like, I know. Well, I don't know what else he said, though. Yeah.
So weird. Everything that happens to you, it's so weird.
I know. The first one I had going there was driving like a maniac. But nice guy, Middle Eastern guy. He was talking in Arabic on the phone, so I asked him.
Oh.
He was like, yeah, I'm from Jordan.
Oh.
And I told him, you know.
Well, you get some weird people.
Mm-hmm.
Mine was pretty normal. I don't talk.
Like, I don't ever talk unless they're like, if they're white, I don't talk. Usually the white people, they don't talk. If they're something not white, they talk.
Really?
That's what I've noticed. But I'm more comfortable with them too. Like, it's like, okay. It feels like I'm in with my like uncle or something.
Oh, gotcha. Because every time I get in the car, I've never talked. I never had like a conversation with an Uber driver.
Usually I don't either. Usually it is like quiet. Sometimes though, there are the ones that like, if they're talkative, it's like, okay.
Oh, I never met one like that. Maybe you give off that vibe.
I don't know.
Who's like easy to talk to?
Maybe. I don't know. I've also been taking Uber since I was like 12, so.
Why 12?
That was when Uber first came out. I was in 7th grade.
But why'd you take Uber then?
Because no one could pick us up, me and my sisters up from school. So my dad used to just get us an Uber and we would go home.
Oh, gotcha. Anyway, that happened. What time was it when you got back home?
What time is it now? 9:45. So I got home at like 7 something, maybe.
Okay. And then did you eat something?
Nope.
Why?
I was going to like DoorDash something. Oh my god, please remind me, I need my wallet.
Yeah.
Okay. I was gonna DoorDash something, but then when I got home from doing nails, I started eating Takis on an empty stomach. And then my stomach just felt messed up. So I was like, nothing sounds good now. So that's why I didn't really eat.
Did you eat lunch?
Mm-mm.
Oh, so you only ate Takis today?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay. You ate Takis, and what did you do until I came?
I watched TikTok.
For how many hours?
Like one.
1 hour?
Yeah, and then I talked to my friends too.
Oh, the usual group chat?
Yeah.
Gotcha. Should I explain what happened today?
Yeah.
Over text first.
Oh,
my I was very God. At this point, it's like every time
you're just gonna call me out for something.
I see you doing that. It's like a comedy now.
Okay.
Like funny.
Mm-hmm.
So when did I call you? I think I called you 5:45, 5:40
something. Yeah.
And then I called you 5:45. I called you 5:40 because I know that on Friday they close at the library close at 6. So I wanted to see if I could just head over to your place and just record.
Mm-hmm.
It's nice to have like a break in between like edits. And I called you. You didn't pick up. I think I called you multiple times, actually.
Many times.
If I'm calling someone, I usually call about like a few times before I like give up. And you texted me with wait, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then, okay. I think I called you again around 6 something. When I was going down, I think I called you again. Wait with a lot of T's, right?
Yeah.
And I was like, Okay. Something was happening, and then I went to another building to find a spot to edit, but it was full. So I called you again. Where are you? And then you picked it up that time, I think.
Oh, yeah. And then I was done.
No, actually, I think I just texted you. You didn't pick it up, so I just texted you. Yo, I'm heading over there. Get ready.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And then you texted me. Oh, did you text me something?
Yeah, they think so.
You said something about nails?
Mm-hmm.
Wait, can I see your... Can I see that? Oh, and then you texted me, bro, I'm not there. I'm doing my nails. And I was already like walking to my car though.
Oh, to come to my place?
Yeah,
oh.
To your place.
Well, good
and
thing
then I was out. Like,
oh my God.
And I was like, Heather, why didn't you tell me that you had nails? Yeah, why?
I was thinking about it before I left because I was like, okay, if he calls me or does anything, I know that I can't be on my phone, like, can't use my hands. But then I was like, well, no, I don't think we're going to do it anyways until like 8. That's what we said yesterday.
Now you started lying over it. Yeah, you started lying right there. Right there. Nuh-uh.
But that's why I didn't tell you before.
Mm.
Because when I texted you, wait, I had one free hand.
Actually, not telling me is fine. Oh, we're going to do it at 8. It's fine. I'm not going to tell him. That's fine. That part was fine. But what did you text me? Wait, right?
Yes.
But you didn't tell me why and what was going on. And I was like, okay. I just texted, get ready soon. I'm heading over there. And then you text me nails. Oh, bro, I'm not there. I'm doing my nails.
Mm-hmm.
And I asked you, instead of typing wait, why didn't you just type in nails?
Because just wait, give me a second until I'm done with all of this and then I will call you.
What happened to all the rest of the sentences? You just said wait. And I'm like, okay. So actually, I texted you poop sign and the question mark.
Oh,
because
yeah.
I thought you were in the bathroom or something. So I was like, okay, maybe she's in the bathroom.
No.
That's what I was thinking.
Oh.
I didn't think you had like a big plan.
Mm-hmm.
You didn't mention anything the day before that.
Uh-oh.
So I was like, oh, she might be in the bathroom. She's talking to someone. But I didn't really think about that much. Yeah. So I was like, Heather, not picking up my phone, just saying wait, and then suddenly just saying while I'm walking to my car, I'm not there yet. I'm doing my nails. What do you think about this? What do you think?
I couldn't. Wait is just faster to type. Like,
oh,
wait, son. I can't wait. Da 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 da. And then if I would have said that, you would have been like, how long? Where?
Mm.
How much longer? Like, nah, I can't deal with that. So it's just wait.
Hmm. Anyway, I was a little. I wasn't like that mad, but. Like, oh, it's a Heather thing going on again. She brings things up, but she never tells me exactly why or what.
Very.
So if you can next time, instead of just telling me wait,
okay, give you more detail.
Please respond with some more like actual meat, uh-huh. Like the
more detail.
It doesn't have to be like just like a. If there's a sentence, there's like a few words that's really important, right? It's
yeah.
Like if I'm in the bathroom, it's like poop. That's like really important. If you just text me that, then I'll know. Oh, bathroom.
Uh huh.
Like nails. Oh, what? Sick.
Mm.
Groceries. Oh, groceries.
Mm.
So Starbucks.
Something a little bit more than
like,
wait.
Yeah. Words that would describe everything.
Got it.
Okay.
I will do that.
Yeah. It was very confusing for me. I was like doing my nails. Yeah. But it wasn't as bad as previous ones, so I don't. Oh. It's fine.
Okay, I get a
pass.
I
don't really care. No, I don't really care.
Okay.
Just like
perfect.
Yeah. Boy, it was kind of funny though, doing the Heather thing, bringing it up and not even telling me like what it is. Okay.
I know.
I had to get it out there.
I have a problem.
No, it's fine. Unless it's like not even showing up, it's usually fine. So. Anyway, I'm gonna tell my day.
Go ahead.
Because I did a decent amount of things. And
let's hear it.
Some interesting things happened
today. Oh, let's hear it. Yeah,
many things. So, today, I told you that I ordered a new phone, right?
Oh, yeah.
It came today. My pickup time was 11 o'clock.
Mm-hmm.
So I got up at 8 o'clock.
Oh.
So I did my workout, shower, eat, and head out. I got my phone. I didn't even tell people. I didn't post it on my story or anything. Da 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 da.
Wow.
Yeah.
Do you like it?
I don't really care that much. I thought the camera quality would be like way better, but it's about the same, honestly. I was expecting some like really clear colors.
Yeah, like a very distinct difference.
It got a little bit better. It's mm-hmm. a blurry background. It's better, but it didn't meet my expectations. But anyway, I got that. And out back home, I tried to move all my, like, transfer all my files, right? Mm-hmm. But somehow it didn't work, the Wi-Fi or something. Mm-hmm. It was too slow. So I had to go to school, transfer that, and then edit that. Everything's fine. Oh, also, I just ordered, like, the case from Amazon.
Mm-hmm.
And when you look at like this
by the camera,
the edge by the camera, it looks like glue. It's like cheap glue. Do you see it? Is it supposed to be like this? Like around this? It looks,
I know, like what you mean. Glue. Yeah, here. Yeah.
Like the whole thing.
Yeah.
It looks really cheap, like cheap glue just made with 3D printer. You know what I mean?
Are you going to keep it? I think it's fine.
Wait, is it? Well, the thing is, I also have to think that I also have to put into consideration that since it's bigger, they'll have to use more stuff to cover that.
Yeah, so it's kind of always gonna look popping.
Yeah, it's gonna popping, which means it's gonna I'll be able to see like the material.
True.
More. Do you think that the Apple case is like this too? I haven't seen it.
Yeah, I wouldn't know.
You don't know? But I didn't like that. I don't like how Apple makes the circle thing and the like a lollipop thing.
Huh?
On their clear cases.
Oh.
The MagSafe thing.
Yeah.
I hated that. That's why I ordered it.
Dude, I have an Apple case. It sucks ass.
Yeah, it sucks ass. Like
it's peeled and everything. It's the worst.
Oh, wait, what is it called?
I don't know. The case?
Yeah.
I don't know, but
they have the new, like,
ripped.
You like
haven't even had it for a year.
The case?
The case, yeah.
Oh,
it's destroyed.
The case is like garbage.
It is, yeah. It's like ripped and everything.
Well, I don't say garbage. No, no, I don't wanna talk
about it. It's not good quality.
It's not good quality.
Mm-mm. I was expecting better.
I also saw that they have a new, what is it, the it's not leather, but woven, woven. How do you even pronounce
woven,
it? Woven,
I think.
Woven something. It's not leather.
Mm.
It's like maybe it's leather. That feeling.
Yeah.
But that didn't look good. The lollipop thing didn't look good. So I was like, I ordered this, but it looks really cheap. So I'm like, is it supposed to be like this? Or is it...
Just... Yeah. was I don't it even the think case? It looks bad though. It's fine. At all.
It's literally like super glue.
You know what I mean? Yeah, like a hot glue gun. Yeah, they a just hot glue gun.
Well, anyway, that happened. I was debating whether I should get it or not, but I didn't get it. And then I was trying to get Chipotle today.
Mm-hmm.
I ordered it online. Because after you said something about nails, I was like, okay, I'm going to go eat then. I can't wait like 40 minutes. So ordered Chipotle, went there for 20 minutes. It just said order processing.
Oh.
It was supposed to be ready at 6:40. But for 20 minutes.
It was just sitting there.
It was just sitting. Sitting at order processing.
Did you go there or like?
So after 30 minutes, I was like, okay. I didn't get my order. And they were like, oh, get in line. And show them your order or something. And then I got in line. They were missing a lot of ingredients. I was like, okay, I'm not going to get it. So I tried to get a refund, but they were like, oh, call to this number. I was like, okay. Got into my car. Went to Qdoba instead, right next to it.
Mm-hmm.
Next Whole Foods. When I called them and explained everything, I got a refund, I think. I didn't check. But they gave me a one free entree.
Oh.
So everything was fine.
Chipotle is usually so like
chill with.
Yeah, they'll always give you something for free.
Yeah.
You just like, complain about anything, they'll be like.
So everything went fine. I felt good. And then when I was driving back home, that's when you called me. When are you coming, Jota? And I was like,
you're like,
I just got my food.
Oh.
I had to get my refund. Yeah.
Wait, and then what? Where did you eat it? In the car?
No, I went back home.
Oh.
I went back home.
And then went back home.
I had it. And I told you I was going to go practice before.
Did you?
I come here. I gave up my practicing.
Wait, I thought you practiced.
No.
I thought you ate and then practiced.
But the thing is, I know that you were going to complain about that.
Yeah, we're not going to do that. That amount of time, it took you that long to eat?
It took me about 40 minutes.
2 hours.
40 minutes.
It's like 2 whole hours from the time I called you.
Think about it. 7:14, I went in there to get my refund, Chipotle. When I got home, it was around 8 o'clock.
Okay. Yeah,
that makes sense. 14, oh, get in line. Okay, get a refund. Okay, it's like 7:40 now.
Mm. Are you still going to practice, though?
Yeah, probably. I mean, we'll see. I think so. And the 7:40, I got to go to Qdoba, wait in line again, get my order, drive back home. I set up everything. I clean my hands, you know, do blah, 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 take up my stuff. 8 o'clock. And I start eating. 8:40. And then I chew my gum, look at my phone a little bit. I go brush my teeth. Leave around 8:55. And I'm here.
Hmm.
Right? Also, when I was, you know, in front of Joe's, not the sidewalks. I'm blanking out the crosswalks.
Yeah.
I was jaywalking and this guy was just honking at me. I was almost there. I was almost like done like crossing. And the guy was like,
oh, why'd you jaywalk?
Everyone jaywalks there.
Nobody jaywalks.
But I was almost done. I saw that, oh, he's far away.
Yeah, like it shouldn't have been a big deal.
Yeah. It was a black dude.
Oh wow. He was pissed.
Yeah, the car was kind of falling apart. That vibe.
Were people staring at you?
I mean, people were staring at the car because the car was honking. Like, what the fuck? Anyway, that happened. On top of that, you start acting like that. Oh, Mike's coming. Anyway, that happened. That happened. And then, yeah, a lot of things happened. I gave him a practice to come here. Yeah. But it's fine.
Yeah.
After this, I'm gonna go practice. I also gave up my editing. Because I knew that you were gonna complain if I come too late. You're gonna be like, no, we're not gonna do it again. That's too late. I told you I need to be in bed by 10 o'clock or something.
Yeah. No, actually, yeah. Because my grandparents are coming tomorrow.
I thought they were coming today.
It's on Saturday.
On Saturday? They come on Saturday.
Mm-hmm.
What time?
11.
11?
11, 11:30, I think.
A.M.?
Mm-hmm.
When are they leaving then? Like 2?
Wait, what?
When are they leaving?
No, they're taking me to, like, where they live. They're not staying here. They're just picking me up. We have to go do something. And then they're gonna drive me back here.
Wait a sec. So they're gonna come pick you up?
Yeah.
Go all the way back. Where do they live?
Dearborn.
Dearborn? How long is the drive?
Like 30 minutes. Not far.
Okay. 30 minutes and then do what?
Can't stay on here.
Why? Just eating lunch?
Yeah, yeah. I'm not gonna tell you.
It's gonna be fine.
Right? No.
What are you gonna do?
Like,
well, yeah, we have something to do. We're probably gonna get lunch. She was like, you can stop and get lunch and blah, 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 and then we'll drive you back. So.
Yeah, I know, but why is it a big deal, though? What are
like? No, nothing. I just have something to take care of.
But why can't you tell on the podcast?
It's
something that you do with your grandparents.
It's personal. No, I'm not gonna tell you. I'm not gonna. Okay, I'm not gonna tell you. I'm not gonna tell you.
You bring it up and you never tell. What is it?
I'm not gonna tell you.
Is it about you or is it about them?
About me.
Wisdom teeth?
No.
What can it be then?
Mm-hmm.
I'm so curious now.
It's irrelevant. Anyways.
It's irrelevant?
Mm-hmm.
I really want to know.
Mm-hmm.
What is it that you brought it up? You tell me.
No, it's nothing.
You tell me.
I don't want to say it. It's fine.
You don't want to say it?
Anyways, so yeah, that's what I'll be doing tomorrow. Morning and afternoon.
Please, Nimi George WM.
No,
please,
hate
comments.
No.
Please, hate comments.
Wait, also, you didn't post any podcast for like the past 3 days.
I didn't have time.
What do you mean, didn't have time? I thought you just automatically have them.
I have to edit first, I have to export it, and then I have to upload it.
Got
I was going to do it today, but.
No time.
Yeah. I was editing a video. Yeah. Picking up this, transferring this data.
Busy boy.
Busy day today. So what time are you coming back tomorrow? 3?
I would say around 3.
Oh, that's fine.
Fuck.
That's perfect. Why?
I just procrastinated my homework all week long and everything's due Monday, so I'm kind of screwed, but it's fine.
You only have to do 2 more hours of homework.
It's fine.
Anyway, we have to get into the topic.
We have like 5 minutes left.
Oh, we have 20 minutes left.
What?
We were just talking about our day and just... Should I change the name of the podcast? Not the name.
Yeah, I think
the
so.
The episode?
Yeah. It could be like something about Uber drivers.
Okay. Well, we can talk about Uber drivers then.
We did. But we can continue.
Yeah, we can continue with Uber.
Okay.
Something Uber. I'll come up with the... We can come up with clickbait title after.
Yeah.
Uber. If I really think about it, I don't really use Uber that much. Because I don't go places.
Yeah, plus you have your car.
I don't really go anywhere other than going to the airport, basically.
Mm.
That's only like 3-4 times a year.
Yeah.
What about you?
Like, how often do I use them? I take one whenever I go to the train.
Oh. How much does it cost?
It's like $6.
Oh.
Yeah. Because it's short.
The train really. Station?
Yeah.
Oh, it's I know where far. That is. Mm-hmm. I always drive by.
Yeah, it's like not crazy far, so it's fine. Yeah.
Do you think Ubers are expensive?
Yeah, depending on the time of day and like where you want to go, yeah.
Because from Ann Arbor to Detroit, it usually cost 45 to 50.
Sometimes more. I've taken Uber many times from here to like where, like home, like $70. This is like an hour long. Not in like 45 minutes.
Oh, of course. Like you, I was talking about like airport, Detroit.
Yeah.
That was like 45.
Yeah.
But so when you're going back home, do you always have someone pick you up or?
Not anymore. Now I usually just do the train.
How much is the train? 15.
Like $18.
Okay. Do you only use Uber or do you like rotate Lyft? And what's the other ones?
I never use Lyft. I only use Uber.
Why don't you use Lyft?
Some like, very rarely I will just to, like see if it's cheaper. Which one's cheaper too. On?
It's usually Uber's cheaper, right?
Yeah. That's why I don't know. I just always have always just used Uber.
I think I used Lyft when they had like a promotion deal or something.
Yeah, oh my god, I have a story. It's not like super crazy, but like, oh, when one of our friends from Mexico was visiting, me and my cousin dropped him to the airport, and then I wanted to come back here to my apartment, so I got an Uber from like somewhere near the airport back to here, and it was like 3:00 in the morning. And then the guy comes, he picks me up, he has a Tesla. Okay, so he goes, do you mind if I pull over to the side and charge my car as I am in his car? And I was like, he's like, it's gonna die, like I
probably it makes sense, I believe. Took a shower today though. The fly went into your mouth. Like down to your down the throat. did you eat it?
Anyways, I'm pretty sure that
he was trying to charge.
Yeah, and I was like, in the moment, I was like, yeah, okay, that's fine. And then he kept driving, and then he asked me again, is it fine? And I was like, I mean, like, if you can keep going, like, I would prefer that you just keep going. Like, it's the middle of the fucking night, like, no. So then I did, he didn't stop. He just kept driving, so I don't know what happened to him, but yeah.
Oh. what was he like? How old was he?
Like middle aged, 40 something maybe.
Oh. He was nice.
Yeah, but like I'm in the car with a random man at 3:00 in the morning. Like, don't tell me you're about to stop. Like,
oh. Gotcha. The way there flies around you, is it because of like the scent?
I don't know.
I think it's a scent because it's like a chemical. Do you know anyone who had bad experiences
with Uber?
Yeah, or just like Uber, Lyft. I don't know anyone. Everyone had good experiences.
Yeah, generally I've always had good experiences. I feel like they've been good.
Do you think they're safe?
I personally feel safe.
Right?
Like, and I've taken, like, again, I take them, like, at all times of day. Middle of the night, regular time, like,
yeah.
I've never felt, like, scared or anything.
Yeah. Because I know that before Uber came out, everyone was talking about, how can you get on, like, a stranger's car and trust them?
Mm-hmm.
No one thought that it would be normalized.
Yeah. They all used to get so weirded out, though, whenever they would pick me and my sisters up from school, because you have to be 18 to use Uber.
And how old were you guys?
My older sister at the time was like 14. I was like 12 11, and my younger sister was like 10.
Oh, like really came.
We were bad. All in our school uniform. We come out with our backpacks. Like this one guy, I remember when he took us home, he's like, I can tell you girls aren't 18 and you have to use Uber. He's like, if anything were to happen, like car accident or anything, like, you know, I could get in trouble for like picking you guys up, blah, blah, blah. But like we literally had no one to pick us up from school. So like, yeah.
Oh.
But they would always ask like, is this a school? And they'd be like, yeah.
That's funny. Well, when was it exactly? When did Uber come out?
2014, I think.
Oh.
I'm pretty sure. Yeah. I think that's when it came out.
Something was like it 2014?
Yeah.
What was the most expensive Uber like car that you got on? Were there like just like really fancy Uber drivers? I've never seen an expensive car that was doing like an Uber thing.
No.
Right. Well, Tesla is like a decent one though. Why do you think he was doing that though?
I mean, I could see that it was saying like he needed to charge it, but then he was also telling me, oh, you're my first person of the day. So I'm like, okay, why wouldn't you have, shouldn't it be fully charged? Oh, like, why is it dead at 3 o'clock in the morning? Oh. Like,
Because I sometimes see it online where a guy has like a camera and he'll post a clip of
the person,
like the interaction that they're having.
Oh yeah.
And sometimes it's fun.
Mm-hmm.
Uber drivers chill. Everyone's yeah, I feel chill. Like it doesn't happen to
last,
me.
Last semester when I was at the hotel, I was taking Ubers to class every day. There was a few, like this one guy was telling me a whole story about how he met his current girlfriend at some like CD store or something.
What CD? Oh, like actual CD?
Yeah.
Oh, way back in the day then.
No, it was recently.
There's a CD store?
Some, like, I don't know, like CD, one of those like no record shops or something.
No one uses CD anymore.
Some people do.
Do you CD?
No, but some people do. They like that aesthetic, that old style.
We can't even put it in the laptop. Whatever,
that's what he told me.
Okay.
He was showing me pictures of her, blah, blah, blah. He's like, yeah, like I just met her like last month. I really like her. All these things. Yeah. There was this other guy. white guy. Oh, I forget it, but then I started talking about, I don't know, I can't remember these interactions anymore, but mm-hmm. there's just been like a few where they bring up like funny stories or like something so random.
Gotcha. Uber driver, wait, let's see the time. Let's do one more about Uber and we can go into the relationship as always, right?
Okay.
Uber. It's not a question, but just the thought, because in like a few years, the self-driving cars will be the Uber. No one would have to get in the car.
No one's driving.
So you just
order it.
Do the app, accept, pay or something, whatever you do. That's the key. So you open it and you start the thing. It'd be nice.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to that.
It's so self-driving. Scary. Okay.
Relationship. Maybe every time we should come up with one question for a relationship one.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe. Just like a one. Just Google. I'm just going to copy 949 podcast. they have a good question. They have good questions. 9-4. Oh, I have a good one.
Okay.
How do you know if a girl is flirting or being nice? How do you differentiate those two?
This is a tough one.
Because let's say you're at like a party situation, right? And then you find someone for the night. Like a party partner, for example. And you talk to them. But sometimes girl thinks, oh, he's just my party partner. Like, I don't really like him. But you guys were hanging out the whole night. So guy would think that, oh, she's into me. So how do you differentiate? Like, how do you know if they're being nice or if they actually like you?
I guess like if they kind of stay by you, like if they're not like
they're gonna stay by you because the guy's the party partner.
Yeah, but then if she's not interested, why would she stay there? She's just gonna walk away.
Because she doesn't know a lot of people, then it's nice to have like a party partner.
Then in this case, I guess you don't know.
Oh, you don't know.
Sorry. I guess you don't know.
Then how do they act after that to know? What can they do?
They would probably like continue like trying to talk to you and stuff like that.
Wow, that's a basic.
I don't know.
You know? Then, okay, it's not a party setting. Let's ask you. You specifically.
Mm-hmm.
How do you behave differently? How should I phrase this? Like, what do you do when you're being nice and what do you do when you're being, like, flirtatious?
Like, I don't know, just...
Don't say, I don't know, it's you.
If I like them, I'd probably, like, initiate the conversation.
No, because you can't say that. Do you know why?
Why?
You initiate conversation with Anthony. That doesn't count.
Not at all in the same way. Like...
No, that doesn't count. You do that too. Your group chat, Raiden.
Okay.
So, you can say that.
Like, I don't know. I would just probably, like, spend more time with them.
You spend time with Anthony, Raiden. It doesn't count. Stop the BS.
I don't know. I don't know what answer you're just looking
think about
for.
It. Just think about it.
And wait, is there like a right answer?
Like, I'll think about it. And if it sounds like a right answer, then I'll give it a pass.
Wait, I actually don't know, though. Like, if I don't like you, I wouldn't talk to you. Even if I was just being nice.
But the thing is, you talk to your guy friends, right?
So what? That's like just me talking to a friend, though.
It's yeah, no so different. You don't feel anything. You're just being a good friend.
Yeah.
So,
I don't know. I guess you can't. You just know.
You're giving a bad advice right here.
I am terrible at advice. I'm sorry. Especially with this topic. I've been asked that before. Like, guys, is she flirting with me or is she just being nice? I don't fucking know.
You don't know?
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know either.
Yeah, I don't know.
Because I've never seen you around, like, someone that you like.
Mm-hmm.
If I've seen that, then I probably would know. But I've never seen you with someone else. Other than, like, your guy friends.
Yep.
Because one of the answers on the 9 for 9 was, if a girl really liked the guy, then she would get really shy.
Probably, yeah, yeah.
Don't say yeah, yeah. Don't just agree
no,
with
okay,
me.
Now that you say that, that's true.
Like, they would tell the tell jokes, they're like really close guy friends.
Yeah.
If they're comfortable, they'll do everything. They're more of them, like, they can be themselves.
Mm-hmm.
But if they get nervous, then more quiet.
Yeah.
Introverted. But I don't know.
I would agree with that.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I would agree with that.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay. I wanna see how you act.
Okay.
In front of someone that you really like, okay. And you get nervous and be like, you squirm. <You're> like. We'll see.
Okay.
Maybe I'll take a video secretly.
Mm-hmm. Expose me.
Yeah.
Okay.
But I know for a guy, I can touch on the guy. For guys, they usually don't even talk.
What do you mean? If they like the girl?
If they don't like the girl, they don't even talk.
Mm.
Think about it. Have you seen guys trying to talk to someone who's not that, like, really attractive looking, or someone that they're not into?
I guess not, if they're not into
that. Have you seen in a party setting, have you seen a guy with some, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Guys are very simple. If they're giving their time, green light. Always. 100%.
Mm. Okay.
Right? But girls, I don't know. I'm a guy, so I can say that for sure, but I'm not a girl, so I can't. They say. But I don't know. How do they act? Like, what do...
I would agree, like, the shy thing.
Other than the shy thing, give me more. Since you're a girl, you know more than me. So at least give me something that I don't know. Like, what do girls do when they like someone?
It doesn't have to be you. Sarcastic. I don't know.
What do they do? Because I know a few, just like the textbook answers, which would be...
Yeah, I don't
know. They'll laugh at their jokes all the time, so they're always laughing. So even though you didn't do that to make her laugh, she would just laugh at you for everything. So the energy is there.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the energy.
Mm-hmm.
Like, why do I feel like I know more about girls than you do.
I don't know.
You don't know? And when they're talking, their whole body would like face the person that they like. And when they're laughing in like a group setting, they'll look at a person that they are attracted to. That one's like 100%.
Yeah.
I see that a lot. And the way they look at the guy, it's very slow.
Direct.
Very slow, like eye contact. Like going.
Like scanning.
It's like very slow.
Yeah. Yeah. Good job.
That's my answer. That's beautiful. I want to know something that I don't know.
Like, I truly don't.
You truly don't?
Nope. Sorry.
Wow. What? What?
I'm gonna go to sleep. Like, I'm so tired.
You're so tired? Should we get Mike on the podcast for a little bit? No? Okay.
He's busy.
Okay. No, you ask one more relationship question because you didn't do anything for the didn't say anything for the question that I brought up.
How do guys find the confidence to go up to a girl that they're interested in?
Like, how can they? Or
yeah.
Oh.
Is it only a specific type of guy, or do you think that they could all do it?
I think it can be learned. 100% it can be learned. It's usually fear of rejection. So, but other than like learning, I see a lot of guys, like, I didn't really ask them, but if I have to guess why they're not asking the girl up front, is because they just think it's not that worth it to like get out of their way to ask the girl.
Yeah.
They don't think that's like important enough for them to take actions. If that's the case, it's very hard to convince them or tell them, oh, you should go up to the girl. It'll never work. I've tried. They never do. So what was the question again? How can they find confidence?
Yeah. Just practicing.
Practice. Because when would they ever find a chance to even go up to a girl and ask them up front? Even now, you don't see it that often.
No.
In class?
Mm.
Maybe if it's a party setting, then it's different. Because all the people who go out to party has intentions.
Mm.
And they know what they want. So you see that a lot there. But regular, just normal day to day, you don't see that. There's specific types. Yeah. I don't think like you can like change them to act that way.
Okay.
Like people who go to parties, they will approach girls for sure.
Yeah.
But they don't. So what time is it?
Way past time.
We started 28. Anyway, okay. Thank you guys for watching/listening. I'll see you guys in the next video.